There are no plans to upgrade present arrangements. The other is that tough security cordons would alienate servicemen from the community here, scoring another propaganda blow for the IRA. John Cookson, IRN, at the Roy Barracks, West Germany.
British airports are again getting clogged with holidaymakers because of a severe disruption to flights. This time it's being caused by a computer breakdown. The fault in the main air traffic control computer at West Drayton, Middlesex, means controllers have to write by hand all the flight progress information normally charted by the computer. Everything is being slowed down and controllers are having to handle less traffic. The longer the computer is out of action, the worse it's going to get. Police are hunting a gunman who jumped out of a car and threatened two girls as they walked home in Huddersfield, West Yorkshire. Police say the car pulled up and one of two men inside grabbed one of the girls and threatened her with what appeared to be a handgun. The other girl waved frantically to people driving past, forcing the two men to flee. Home Office scientists are carrying out a detailed examination on an aerosol can after it blew up in a house in Bristol, injuring a woman and her baby. William Ronkin reports.
Firemen were called and found the woman suffering from burns to her hands, arms and knees. Her two-year-old toddler also had to be treated for minor burns after her hair caught alight. Both have now been released from hospital and are said to be in a comfortable condition. Avon Fire Chief Ian Jeffries says the exact cause of the explosion is still unclear, but is warning people to treat aerosols with great care.
It must be borne in mind that even if it's a non-flammable material inside the can, very often the propellant gas is in fact flammable.
Police say they're now waiting to interview the woman about the incident. William Ronkin, IRN, Bristol.
A flight of doves, a mournful tolling of bells, and a silent prayer has marked the 43rd anniversary of the world's first atomic bombing. Thousands of people gathered at Hiroshima's Peace Memorial, and throughout the city, traffic stopped and people bowed their heads in silence, remembering the moment on August the 6th, 1945, when an American B-29 dropped an atom bomb on the port city. A woman is recovering after being knocked down and pinned against a garden wall by a runaway hut. The mobile site hut, being towed through Walmsworth in South Yorkshire, broke free, mounted the pavement and hit Anne Sutton. She's been treated in hospital for a shoulder injury, bruising and shock. Cricket, in the final Cornhill Test match at the Oval, England are 127 for 5. That's a lead of 149 runs over the West Indies. Captain Graham Gooch is still there on 46. Independent Radio News. Now we cross to the Oval for an update on the score from Dominic Allen.
During the morning session, England added 64 runs for the loss of two wickets. Foster was first to go. He was caught at backward square by Logie hooking Benjamin. He'd made 34 and done a splendid job as night watchman, putting on 53 with Gooch for the fourth wicket. And shortly before lunch, Maynard was out, caught and bowled by Benjamin for 10, an unlucky dismissal in that the ball went from pad to bat. Gooch is still there, 46 not out. Capel has made 3. England are 128 for 5 at lunch. They lead by 150. Dominic Allen, IRN Sport at the Oval.
Now the weather, sunny and hot all day long, the temperatures reaching 26 centigrade, 79 Fahrenheit, with just light breezes. News and weather on LBC Radio.
The Schreiber sale is on. And what a sale. There's massive savings on all kitchens and bedrooms, with over 30% off selected ranges. And special reductions on many appliances too. So come along to your Schreiber showroom and pick up these bargains now. Today from 9:30 to 5:30 at 101 Baker Street, Chase Side Southgate, Broad Street Teddington, Belmont Road Uxbridge and High Street Watford.
Kleenex Country Collection Kitchen Towel. Now there's a long name if ever I heard one. Still, I suppose they call it that because it's ever so long, just like the country. I mean, people go for long country walks, don't they? But I wonder why they didn't call it Kleenex Non-Stop Express Train Kitchen Towel then. That's ever so long. You can miss that. And it ain't nearly so pretty.
Kleenex Country Collection. Now 40% longer. Length is our strength.
Michael Aspel.
Michael Aspel.
Michael Aspel.
You're an angel to
Food and wine are subjects close to my guest's heart this week, so much so that he's written a learned book called The Theory and Practice of Lunch. He's Keith Waterhouse, creator of Billy Liar and other glories, and the subject of my star profile on LBC Radio with British Airways as well. Take your places, please. The first course is served this Sunday at noon.
Hello.
Hello, this is Susie Walton with Phil Bingham and Steve Crozier. And time off, our holiday travel and leisure programme brought to you in association with Swissair. Today we're taking you to two destinations. Reporter Paul Rowley continues his look at Turkey. Today he takes us to a sulphur bath. And we hear from John Taylor in Switzerland. He reports from the Eiger.
We look at ferries to Ireland, discover the sort of food on offer in Provence, find out...
to business.